Pete Buttigieg is to the left of Barack Obama. He would be the furthest left president that we've ever had in the history of this country. Unfortunately, because we are comparing him now to radical leftist socialists, the guy who supports infanticide, the guy who wants mandated government health care, the guy who wants to take away semi-automatic weapons, even if you happen to have used a naughty word at some point, is seen as a moderate candidate. Pete Buttigieg. I don't care how it's pronounced, that he is
the
moderate in the Democratic Party. Everyone's been hearing this, right? Yes. This is the attack. They're trying to frame it after after New Hampshire and after Iowa.
Right.
And it's this war between Sanders and Pete Buttigieg. Sanders, he's leading in total votes. Buttigieg has slightly more delegates. Well, let's let someone else tell you so that you believe it.
You need 1,991 delegates to win the nomination. This is the beginning of a long road to that Democratic convention in Milwaukee. Take a look at where we are. Buttigieg actually has a two-delegate lead at 23. Sanders, 21. Warren, 8. Klobuchar, 7. Biden down at 6. So Bernie Sanders very well emerges from New Hampshire after a strong showing in Iowa as the national frontrunner at this race.
Look at his face.
But actually, in the way you get the nomination, winning 1,991 delegates, it's Pete Buttigieg who, out of these first two contests, is actually out in front.
Do you see his, how it looks like he just saw the Pillsbury Doughboy on his table. He's like, So just a quick recap. Iowa, people have been asking about the Iowa debacle. I find it incredibly boring. There was an app made by Democrats. It was Shadow Inc., which had only been around a couple of months to calculate the results. The app malfunctioned. And then we found out that Pete Buttigieg made a victory speech, even though there were zero official results, which, by the way, good for you. That's a pimp move, Pete Buttigieg. I actually respect it. Like, hey, I haven't announced a winner. I'm just going to say I'm a winner. Boom.
Well,
can't take that away from me. But that's illegal. I don't really care. By the way, it also turns out his campaign donated over $40,000 to the app company.
What?
And the Iowa Democratic Party, they were caught making errors that strangely always seemed to favor Pete Buttigieg over Bernie, so you can look into it. I understand why people think the deck may be stacked against Bernie. Yeah. I'm not willing to confirm that or say that I agree with you, but I understand why people might sort of express that sentiment. So a lot of Bernie bros think something's fishy's going on. Okay, fine. The dynamic here now is that it's the socialist, Bernie Sanders, versus this sort of centrist. That's what they're trying to create with Pete Buttigieg and Bernie Sanders. But the question really remains, is Buttigieg actually a moderate? You've been fed that a whole lot.
There's no way.
Let's come down. No. Let's get down to brass tacks. Let's start with immigration. Okay, immigration, economics, and we'll get into more social issues. So Buttigieg, when we talk about immigration, I think the first clip we have it's on immigration, right? Yeah, he says that there are 11 million illegals in the United States, and there's some arguments as to that number exactly. Right. But let's use the number that he uses. And he says that there are 11 million illegals in the United States, though, because the economy brought them here. And then he also clarifies that or extrapolates that the mission of ICE is illegal. There you go.
The reason we have 11 million undocumented immigrants is because our economy needed 11 million more people than our system prepared to admit.
What?
So
what?
Another thing we got to do when we do that reform is set it up so that in the future you can review every couple of years how many work-based visas we need to keep our economy going.
When our immigration authorities are given an inhumane, and in my view, in many ways, illegal set of policies to carry out.
Okay, let's clarify what ICE's purpose is, okay? It is to protect America from the cross-border crime and illegal immigration that threaten national security and public safety. So no, Pete, it's not illegal. They're quite literally enforcing the most basic duty of the United States government in ensuring the safety of our borders from people who could potentially break the law and can't be tracked. And the reason that ICE is necessary, and I know that there are a lot of people at the Young Turks and Samantha Bee who say it's a criminal enterprise, you know, they want you to think that it's the Corleones. They're saying, oh, there should be no ICE. It's criminal. We already have a police force. But the reason ICE exists is because there are still illegal immigrants. There used to be in record numbers. Now it's been decreasing. Thank you, Donald Trump. Make America great. Yeah. I appreciate it. I was wrong. Didn't think you would win. 2020 is going to be a landslide. Please come on the show. My point is...
That was a lot.
My point here is... There is a reason that they exist, that they are necessary, and it's because the job wasn't being done. And we'll get to... There are some more reasons as to why that is, Pete Buttigieg. Take a guess. It involves you. First, hit the notification bell if you're watching this on YouTube, or leave a review if you're listening on iTunes, and do consider joining Mug Club, lightofcutter.com/mugclub. Yeah. You get an entire show every day and access to the whole Blaze catalog, along with some additional content from Gerald and Bill and Dave Rubin. Let's move on to healthcare, because a lot of people say, well, he's moderate because he's not a radical. Here's the thing. When you're comparing Pete Buttigieg to a radical socialist who spent his honeymoon in the USSR, he spent his honeymoon in the Zangief level.
True story.
And loved it.
I just want to make clear. Yeah, you might see him as a moderate, but I think it's important to compare him to all past Democrats, including Barack Obama. Barack Obama couldn't even see Pete Buttigieg to his left. He's so far to the left of Barack Obama. So let's keep that in context. Let's go to healthcare. He's seen as a moderate because he wants Medicare for all who want it. That's his plan. That's what he calls it. And that's a government-sponsored plan to people who want it while letting others keep their private insurance as opposed to simply Medicare for all, no other option.
Yeah.
Like Bernie Sanders. So this is really, to be clear, people don't necessarily understand. They say, well, this seems more moderate than Bernie Sanders. Okay, sure, it's a public option, just like Obamacare, but to a far more extreme degree. Let me explain. If you don't enroll in the insurance plan, the Medicare for All, for those who want it, according to Pete Buttigieg, instead of just being fined $695, I think that's what it was, right, under Obamacare?
Under Obamacare,
$700, I don't remember exactly. You'll be instead of that, you'll be automatically registered, if you don't have insurance, in the government program, and you could retroactively owe as much as $7,000 in premiums at the end of the year, even though you never used the insurance.
Oh my gosh.
So it's like, for all who want it, and if you don't want it, well, you're going to pay $7,000 anyway. Well, I thought you said if I want it. Yeah, but then I realized,
oops.
F*** you. And it doesn't end there, by the way, because we go back to the illegal immigration. So you talk about this. It's Medicare for all who want it, which really isn't an option. He wants to extend the government-funded insurance to everyone, including illegal immigrants. Here you go. And for people listening on audio, I'll help translate. He's talking about health care to everyone in the country, to allegedly an illegal immigrant. She's saying, como dice, free shit. Medicare for all who want it, Pete Buttigieg says. That is our solution. And this opportunity to buy this plan is for everyone.
Like that.
Regardless of their immigration status.
What?
Yeah. Say what?
Como dice, free shit. See, at least his Spanish is better than Cory Booker.
That's exactly.
Think about that. You want to create basically mandated. They say it's an option, but you have taxpayer-funded health care. And then you want to extend it to people who are not even citizens. And by the way, do you see now the problem with abolishing an organization like ICE, who are designed to prevent illegal immigration, while you are simultaneously incentivizing it? And you are incentivizing it, by the way, let's be honest, Pete Buttigieg, you've never done anything successfully yourself in your own life. You are incentivizing it by footing the bill at the American taxpayers' expense. They don't care about the American worker. People wonder you've seen all of these states that have flipped over. I don't think I've ever been more wrong about anything in my life when I said there's no way Donald Trump wins Michigan.
Yeah, I know. Yeah.
There's no way, because it was such a working class kind of union state, and the unions were bought and paid for by obviously Democrats. And then Hillary Clinton just screwed it up.
She did everything possible to lose them.
It is remarkable to me. But these people don't feel represented by you. Why? Because according to Bernie Sanders, mind you, anyone making over $29,000 a year would have to pay more for this government-funded health insurance program, and so the American taxpayer will be subsidizing illegal immigrants according to their own words. It doesn't mean that the American taxpayer, the average American worker, is racist. It doesn't mean that they hate brown people. It means that they don't want to be forced into a healthcare system that they don't want to be a part of. A lot of them like their private insurance, and they certainly don't want to be forced to pay for people who have no business being here in the first place, many of whom don't pay any taxes, and the ones with face tattoos are animals. Not all of them, I want to be clear. I don't want you to say Trump, I'm calling all Mexicans animals. No. Just the ones with the face tattoos who do gang initiations where they steal Gran Torinos. Let's move on to guns. This is another one, and this is a really hard issue for the left because you have a lot of people. Look at Bernie Sanders. He's from Vermont. It's as liberal as it. It's the place of Ben and Jerry, for crying out loud. And you don't even need a permit at all to carry a gun, open or concealed. They have the most liberal gun laws in the country. There are plenty of Democrats who are still pro-Second Amendment. This is a real problem for the Democratic Party. Pete Buttigieg, he signed off on all of the Democrats' most radical gun control proposals. And I want you to watch this clip because it's very, very telling in his own words as to why he is so pro-gun control and sweeping, constricting gun control legislation.
Closing the hate loophole, the Charleston loophole, domestic abusers, enacting red flag laws, extreme risk protection orders, banning the sale of assault weapons like what I carried in Afghanistan. We know what we have to do. The question is, how do we make sure that this time really is different? Because every time we say this time is different. And all of the plans, of course, I think my plan is the best. So does everybody else.
Of course.
All of them are multiplied by zero if we don't actually get something done. And so this is not just a question about policy. This is a question about power.
There it is. It's a question about power. Yeah. That's what it is. It's not about policy. It's a question about power. Because what would be more empowering to a bloated bureaucratic federal government than removing your ability to say no at some point down the line? Yep. That's really what the Second Amendment is. People understand. They talk about a war. It's not about a civil war. And of course, I'm not advocating any kind of civil unrest right now. But what the Second Amendment is truly about, right? You have the First Amendment. You have the right to say whatever you want. The Second Amendment allows you the right to defend saying no. Well, you're going to have to do this. No. You're going to have to pay for health care for illegal immigrants. No. Yeah. That's what the Second Amendment is not. Or you're going to have to be enslaved. Take your pick. Name any corrupt government throughout the history of man. We act like we're somehow beyond this.
Right, yeah.
We act like we're somehow beyond. Slavery goes on across the world. You have people across the modern Western world who are jailed for jokes.
Yeah.
The Second Amendment allows you to say, hey, we're going to take you to prison because you made a joke. No. That's the express purpose of the Second Amendment. That's why they talk about it being about power. Something else that I think is important here, the hate loophole. Democrats have been trying to pass these bills, the hate loophole, when I looked into it a little more, that would make it illegal to own or purchase a firearm if you've been convicted of a misdemeanor hate crime. So that's important because right now, if you're convicted of a violent crime or an actual felony, obviously you cannot purchase a firearm. We already have those laws. Yeah. What is a misdemeanor hate crime? What would you have to do to get charged with it? Okay. So here's a specific example in looking it up. There were these students at a University of Connecticut. Okay. Yeah. They were goofing off, and by the way, not condoning these actions, so let's be clear.
Of course.
They were yelling increasingly offensive words back and forth. It was like, you remember the penis game when you were a kid?
Right. Yes.
You say penis.
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 Ha.
Penis.
Penis. Penis. Penis! It's not really a challenge because I'm a host. So the kids were doing this, but they were doing a variation, from what I understand, offensive words back and forth. Some other students filmed them saying the N-word. Again, not saying you should yell the N-word, of course not. They were charged with a misdemeanor hate crime. My gosh. Just saying a slur, not even at anyone, and you could lose your Second Amendment rights, your God-given right to protect your house and home. Imagine that. When you're a kid, and by the way, penis could also, the penis game, comment below if you've ever played the penis game. Okay, I'm not saying this to try and be shocking. It was a very common game in high school. Let me know if you've played it, because now that could be a hate crime if you say it around someone who's gender fluid, and they could be really upset.
Might get triggered.
20 years down the line, there's a robber at your house, and you don't have your .357 next to your bedside because you mentioned male genitalia across the bathroom from someone who had male genitalia but claimed they were a woman. Thanks, Pete Buttigieg. Climate change. Let's go to climate change. Pete Buttigieg, this is so funny. He supported AOC's Green New Deal.
Oh, we're going to get the wiki now.
Which I don't even know how, if you can go back and watch that video where I read the entire Green New Deal on camera. It's six pages. Like, if you bought a used car, your Carfax is longer than the Green New Deal.
Not a lot of substance.
And not only that, but Pete Buttigieg went as far to, while we're talking about the moderate, claim that the climate change was a big cause of the Syrian war, and that if you eat hamburgers or straws, you are part of the problem. Don't take my word for it.
And migration crises are increasing because of things like droughts and fires that are accelerated by the problems in our climate. There's some evidence that this contributed, for example, to the Syrian evidence, civil war.
I think we think about it mostly through the perspective of guilt. You know, from using a straw to eating a burger, am I part of the problem?
Oh, really? Well, Pete, problem, because I think some folks are missing.
Wow. Every one of the things.
Is his mouth ever closed? Let's go to abortion. This is another one. Again, the moderate candidate, Pete Buttigieg. Yeah. Let me know what you think. Buttigieg made waves for saying that there's no place, by the way, for pro-life Democrats in the party.
Yeah.
So that's what people know. And they thought, well, that's kind of maybe off color. They think maybe it's a one-off. No, it's not. Because he also refuses to place any limit on abortion at all, including infanticide. And this isn't a radical position in the Democratic Party. We'll talk about that with Alan Dershowitz a little bit, America's favorite lawyer, after this, because someone must be conflicted if they consider themselves pro-abortion, pro-choice, but they think there are limits. there is no place for you in the Democratic Party. It's actually far more moderate because nearly every major Republican considers there to be exceptions for rape or incest.
Right.
Democrats, none. Not a single candidate outside of Tulsi Gabbard would name a point where you should stop the abortion. So before watching the clip that I'm about to show you, remember, even the pro-choice group, the Guttmacher Institute, they say that most late-term abortions, this is important, are not because of birth defects or because of health of the mother. So when Buttigieg goes on to say in this clip, like, oh, late-term abortions mean there's some kind of terrible health problem, according to his own sources, he's flat-out lying. Now you see the clip.
From pro-life people like me was that you
and
meant
Meghan
a baby
McCain
actually being born and then possible, you know, there's a lot of controversy with Governor Northam and what it means and what time a woman should be able to have an abortion. I just wanted you to clarify because I found that statement to be pretty radical.
Well, I'm just pointing to the fact that different people will interpret their own moral lights and for that matter, interpret scripture differently.
Partial birth abortion is something that was coming up in like I said, Governor Northam, it was a huge controversy when he was running for
All
governor.
Right, Pete,
I think
here comes a
people
layup.
And Democrats, and there are a lot of pro-life Democrats in the country, want to know exactly where your line is because you will be the president if you win.
Right, but my point is that it shouldn't be up to a government official to draw the line. It should be up to the woman who's confronted with the choice.
Invoking infanticide after a baby was born, you'd be comfortable.
Does anybody seriously think that's what these cases are about?
Think
about the situation.
That, yes.
If this is a late-term situation, then by definition, it's one where a woman was expecting to carry the pregnancy to term. Then she gets the most, perhaps, devastating news of her life. We're talking about families that may have picked out a name, maybe assembling a crib, and they learn something excruciating and are faced with this terrible choice.
Ugh.
And I don't know what to tell them morally about what they should do.
She's trying to give him rope to pull in his lifboat. It's like, here you go, here's rope, here's a life story. And he's like, and he's strangling himself
yes,
with it.
Exactly.
And she's just sitting like, hey, what do you think? What do you think? What do you think? Right away. What do you think about stop! Stop!
I can't read it.
As if the cackling weren't enough. Now I gotta deal with your mic pops. It's
oh
just
my gosh.
It's like they're out stupiding each other. So this is completely untrue. It's not only untrue by the source, but let me give you something, a thought exercise here, okay? We know that from the Guttmacher Institute, that's not the case for the vast majority of late-term abortions. Yeah. There's almost no time where a late-term abortion is medically necessary, period, ever. But do you really buy that? Do you really buy that for a second? This is a gross disservice to women who have miscarriages or women who want to have children that are birth complications.
Yeah.
Because if a woman actually had the room painted and a crib up and she's had a housewarming party, a baby shower, and they've done a whole gender reveal, which I guess is also hate speech now. Maybe you won't be able to
Probably
buy an
is.
AR-15 after that. I have no idea, according to Pete Buttigieg. But do you really think that this mom is the kind of mom who is going to abort that baby at 8 or 9 months? If there is a 0.05% chance of that baby living, that mother of course is going to go through with the birth because to them, going through the process of birth is a small price to pay. I'm not saying it's a small price to pay, but to them, even for the possibility
exactly.
that this baby, this human being could be brought into the world. Do you really even believe he's trying to paint a hypothetical scenario to tug on your heartstrings? Let's use it. A mom paints the walls blue. It's going to be a boy. The mom's been taking prenatal vitamins. The mom is not a Planned Parenthood activist. The mom actually wants to have this baby. The mom's gone and had ultrasounds. The mom has already named the baby. And the doctor says the baby's doing well. And all of a sudden, there's a complication where this baby may or may not make it, like a Tim Tebow, at 8 months or 9 months. And you think that mom goes, oh, well, get the forceps. Really?
No.
Really?
Yeah. No.
It's just amazing to me, the dishonesty and the fact that he wouldn't just take the layup and say, well, of course I'm against infanticide.
Yeah.
When people say moderate, okay, if you compare him to Bernie Sanders, again, the guy who honeymooned in the USSR, the guy who said a 90% tax rate is okay. All right, I understand it. But remember they used to say Barack Obama was sort of leading us towards socialism? Pete Buttigieg is so far to the left of Barack. He's well beyond the passing lane. He's just past the median in a ditch, okay? Pete Buttigieg is to the left of Barack Obama. He would be the furthest left president that we've ever had in the history of this country. But unfortunately, because we are comparing him now to radical leftist socialists, the guy who supports infanticide, the guy who wants mandated government health care, the guy who wants to take away semi-automatic weapons, even if you happen to have used a naughty word at some point, is seen as a moderate candidate. Hey, if you like this video, be sure to subscribe. If you're already subscribed, hit the notification bell, hit all notifications. We have new videos that go up every day, as well as, of course, an entire show not available on YouTube at louderwithcrowder.com/mugclub. If you did not like this show, please comment below and address your comments to Gerald. Be sure to do that. Also, his Twitter,